If somebody first visited China in 1978, and the next time he comes there is 2018 today, the first thing he would say is, where am I?
Huge cities, great big buildings, loads and loads of cars, very well-dressed people.
Wow, how did they manage to do that?
我们只要想到中国的改革开放，那么我们心中都会想到邓小平。
A leader who began 40 years of ever-deepening reform.
That people were given the latitude to start their own firms, to work more productively, to make production choices.
It was so poor, but the energy, you could feel the energy.
They had to be very gutsy, and they had to really take risks.
当然，更没想到联想还会在中国里变成一个啊比较大的公司。当时最多的想的就是，我们到底能活几年
？Private enterprise captured China's imagination and ushered in an age of ambition. But for the daring entrepreneurs, it was risky.
有一批不称职的，或者说是以前谋私的这些。必须把它拿掉，这时候的阻力是最大的。但是你必须要做。
The key to China's success is that it's constantly evolving.
If you think about where China is economically today compared to where it was in 1978, it's a country utterly transformed. The impact, not just in China, but on every other country in the world, has been enormous.
Hard to imagine 40 years ago, but today, China's economy is about to become the world's biggest. Together, China's people have achieved this miracle. In their millions, they've made modern China's flourishing economy. This is the story of just a few. The world-beating entrepreneurs.
跳我最四十年改革开放，我觉得就是这四年改革开放，我觉得最让我觉得一件记得住事，就是我们走向了世界，让世界也走进了中国。
The migrant workers who lived the transformation of countryside。
这里都是沙滩，啊，都是在过去都是海边的。
To city。
我来深圳35年了，一个词是吧？它这一句话的概括，确实没有想到的奇迹。
Pioneers came from across the ocean to seize the opportunities offered by the new open door policy.
The ultimate aim is to reach out to the entire nation. I was a trailblazer.
Or exchange secure jobs for the thrill and risk of private enterprise.
不懂事就不怕，而且真的就算犯了错误，还可以再重来。
And now, the new generation is learning and showing.How to build the sustainable and innovative economy of the future.
我从我父亲身上学到了很多东西，包括对这个新鲜事物的接受能力、直觉，认准了一件事情，要坚持。
Travel back in time through more than 4 decades of constant change.To 1978. Like most Chinese people back then, Hong Jianle was living in the countryside.
我来自福建泉州，父母都在家里面都是干农活的。老家当时。确实是很少有这种出路，就是说很少有这种赚钱的机会。原来都是在干农活，干一些田地。从看看父辈们，他们都这样，也不会想说要出哪里赚钱的，还有去做什么事情。
China in 1978 and China in 2018.40 years, the difference is night and day. In 1978, 80% of the people live in rural areas.
With the new economic reforms, people were free to start businesses or to leave the farm in search of work and opportunity.
What I think is absolutely fascinating is that the minute that market forces were introduced, the first things you saw was that when people were given a choice, entrepreneurship flourished.
我们农村的那辈儿挺穷怪，没东西也没钱了，是
吧？我83年去的北京，我那年18周岁，为了生活更好一点吧，去北京找工作干去吧。刚开始是不太好找，因为83年的时候啊，北京呢，那刚开放啊，变化也没那么大，所以找工作挺困难的。只能你又没技术，你只能当小工人。我10年以后吧，我改在那个电信工程，我自己就带队，开始我自己运作了。
8年以后放副驾，我们就上北京去。
反正在外边有势力，就说我干了那么多年，都有哥们儿都挺捧场的，也挺那个休闲的，也觉得挺自由的。反正，我也挺想的，看挺乐观的那时候，钱就比如说也能多挣点，也挺自由的。
Enterprising self-starters like Chen Yung Xuan and pioneering traders were changing towns and villages across China. And now, Deng Xiaoping proposed an altogether more ambitious experiment. In the early 80s, on the southern coast opposite Hong Kong, he established China's first special economic zone.
所以特区又成了中国这个整个制度创新改革突破的一个试验田，就是要引进外来这个投资。
One of the elements of China's successful model is a willingness to experiment. They allowed provinces, especially on the coast, to experiment with opening up to foreign trade.
Geographically specified areas which allowed combination of market forces, foreign financing to experiment and produce goods largely destined for the outside world. This was spectacular.
听说埃森镇改革开放的第一个特区，买了拖拉机就从福建一直开到深圳，这个3天3夜。
Country boy Hung Jianla took his chances in the first wave of migrants to the new special economic zone.
就是到处都是只有田地，只有那种坑坑洼洼的泥土路了。
Over the next 4 decades, his story would mirror that of his adoptive city.
我开始去的时候，深圳城市并不大，就一个小渔村。
This is a special economic zone. What are they thinking? Who's going to come here?
跟我们老家是差不多了，只是工地一直在建设，搞建设的。当时就是每天就是开着拖拉机去那些就是建筑材料。都是每夜就是双手了，任劳任怨的，每天就说有这种活干，然后就觉得也是很满足了，这种精神来支撑着自己的，真的是没有那代人吃苦耐劳的精神，真的是没有现在的生存。
Everybody in Shenzhen came there for a reason from somewhere else. They saw this as a place that you could actually do new things.The freedom was there to do new things.
Now we're looking at the late 80s, and Shenzhen is now booming. You have a real estate development, office towers being built, all kinds of enterprises, factories.
在深圳工作了几年以后，我觉得很适合我，觉得说我有可能就回不去了。
It migrant workers, they were coming from the poorer provinces of China, and although by Western standards their wages were meager, by Chinese standards from where they came, they were riches.
啊，一个朋友，他是做生意的，啊，天天拿着这个包，就爱拿他的包带他的领带，哎，拿领带出来摆一个 pose 啊，试一下。有这种梦想，有这种说以后能不能哎，想赚大钱。
我跟他是同一个村，从这么小咯，开始一起玩呐，从1987年来深圳蛇口上班。我做玩具厂，一修那种玩具里面有一个马达，就分了一个小房间，很高兴啊，能有自己一个小房间，觉得很幸福的了。
In the 1980s, China wanted to do more than just manufacture products for the world. The leadership.Wanted to modernize and upgrade the country's industrial base.
Foreign direct investment was very important in the early development of China. Investment is what generates industry.
China could not buy the technology it needed to upgrade its industries and become competitive.
So the government relaxed the rules and encouraged Chinese state-owned enterprises.
Hi, 你好，
李先生，你好，
你好，
是多年
了，是。
To team up with companies from abroad.
您还是20多年前，
是吗？
One of the first foreign firms to try to enter China's new open door was Coca-Cola.
是不那个宋台山？
宋台山嘛。
哦，我记得了。
American chemist Dr. Peter Li was sent by Coca-Cola to see what was possible.Local boy Du Jinfeng was a new recruit to Beijing-based state-owned enterprise Kofco.
我是老北京人，在北京生活过三代的。我家呢就负责，找一份工作给你。到了这个公司以后呢，我们。都很兴奋嘛，根本就没有听说过可口可乐。当时我的理想就是去一个外贸的企业嘛。
I was born in China. I was naturalized and I became an American citizen. So I could appreciate the East and the West better than most. I was trying to bring into China 1.3 billion people, the untapped market. Certainly, why not?
It was very difficult for investment to come into China.
Foreign investors, how can this be made consistent with what I call socialism?
There was a tremendous amount of resistance. Coca-Cola had been perceived as incompatible with China.
After years of discussion and negotiation, Peter Li and Kofco signed a deal to cooperate.
What I call mission accomplished. I was overjoyed.
The collaboration was advantageous for the foreign firms because it gave them a place in the Chinese market and for China because it represented an ability to learn more advanced Western practices.
80年9月份上的班参加的工作，觉得我们的工作很新鲜。
Deng wanted China to learn from what other countries had done.
这就是第一次喝可口可乐的感觉。它的味道呢，有点像中药。这个味道确实接受不了。
We agreed to build everything from scratch. At that moment, they had need for so many things. The bottling plant was officially opened April 1981. The opening of a new dimension.We were received by a vice premier, the first foreign company ever to hold a reception inside the Great Hall of People. It was a very mind-boggling moment for me.
Both sides experienced culture shock and setbacks, but these partnerships, like the special economic zones, brought in much-needed foreign exchange.
The foreign partner was not only bringing capital in, they were bringing ideas and technology, foreign management systems, foreign marketing, and the Chinese side was absorbing it.
All of those are ways in which Chinese firms caught up.
I think if it wasn't for foreign investment, the reforms and the changes and transformations that we see today would not have happened.
你还是在可乐公司？我还在。
We have engineer from the U.S., Japan, U.K.
平时呢，见老外呢也比较少，所以呢也觉得比较新鲜，觉得这种生活还比较惬意。
Cook, take the message. You want to come here, you have to adapt. That we also need to be patient. We need to grow at the same pace as the opening up.
Beijing in the early days of reform was the place to be for experimentation and new ideas. Especially in the northwest of the city, where the top universities cluster.
大学毕业以后完全是被好像被绳索捆住，什么事情也做不了。
所以邓小平在他整个的改革这个在中国这个改革的，他知道中国改革的进程当中，解放思想，
改革开放呢，把我身上的绳子解开了，所以我很想试试自己能做什么事情。
Here, visionaries were beginning to lay the foundations of what would become China's Silicon Valley.
中关村呢，在1984年前后开始呢，有很多科技人员下海办了公司。现在是我自己选择的路。
Today, Liu Chuanjia is known as the godfather of Lenovo. Back then, he was a researcher at the Chinese Academy of Sciences.
由于我们当时都是科技人员，既没有经验。中国的这个电脑最集中的地方一开始呢就是在中关村。当时我们办公司的时候呢年龄都比较大了，当然实际上办高科技公司来讲啊，这么大年岁的人实际是啊还是有很多困难的啊。最刚开始的时候叫中国科学院计算技术研究所新技术发展公司，一个很长的名字，这样的话我们的身份地位可以提高一点，可以更好的得到一点别人的信任。因为在那个时候私人办公司是非常被人看不起的，就发现了这间已经作废的传达室是空的，我们就申请。今天大家看起来这个房子很破旧，但是我们在刚一开始搬进去的时候已经非常高兴了。
Despite these small beginnings, Lenovo now has 52,000 employees and the company is worth $43 billion.
我也不知道后边公司会办得这么大，当时只是想我们到底能办多久啊，能不能活下来，就是能不能存活下来，下边我们做什么啊，总算是一个困难但是充满着希望的一个地方，一个梦的开始的地方。
All over China, people were starting to dream. Farmers.Migrant workers, entrepreneurs, traders. But for some, the changes were too great and were happening too quickly.
There was still a huge debate. The debate being, what should be the role of what I call market forces, the role of foreign investors.
If we're going to talk about one of the great turning points for the modern Chinese economy, we have to look at the year 1992.
一些讲话可能都感觉到邓小平来深圳难行了嘛。
He said, look, my experiment worked. This is the model. We have to now make it a national model.
He said, it doesn't matter what color the cat is, so long as it can catch mice.
And therefore, by making this very visible, public gesture, he was able to symbolize that he would not permit the Chinese economy to go back towards that older, more command-driven model, but would insist on further marketization.
Migrant worker Hong grasped the opportunity Deng's southern tour offered. 有一个发展的大好机会又来了，一些学一些比较精密先进的设备，然后到自己和跟人合作办了一些工厂。Across the bay from Shenzhen is Zhuhai, back then, another special economic zone. Today, part of the Pearl River conurbation.
当时并没有什么目标，说未来我要做一个什么样什么样的人。但是我们有一个很大的特点，就无论是做什么事，这件事一定要做好。我是格力电器的这个董事长。 目前为止有9万员工，到目前为止，全球整个生产基地已经接近有18家。我出生在南京，这是个普通人的家庭。这张是我和我妈妈。 就我母亲，我觉得她特别伟大，她就在于她是在平凡当中，她都是为子女、为她的儿孙们一起。但是自己是有梦想。我最看得住孩子的时候，孩子很小嘛，才2-3岁，你把他放手了以后，就靠母亲来带他的时候，实际上给孩子确实有一点那种亲情感的失落。就人的这一生当中都会有收获，有后悔。 这时候是你是要有选择的，所以当时就到了现在的这个公司，找到一份职业就是搞销售，是国企的原因。因为在那个时代，营销决定了企业生命，但那个时代恰恰又是一个营销的时代。China's
consumer economy continued to develop over the period from the 1980s through to the 2000s.
And wow, people start to buy. They stock their homes with every kind of electrical gadget you can think of until you can't get any more.
Much more fancy television sets, mobile phones, computers, cars.
And China became the new workshop of the world, the new great manufacturing center.
<笑>00年以后吧，我在我们这边发展的，又加上些厂子烧。你现在没有说一买就是最少得3吨煤的，所以它那个销量大了。
China's huge appetite for coal would go on to cause immense problems, and incidentally, bring new opportunities for Chen's son, but that was later. Back in the 1990s, what Chen saw was a business opportunity to be grabbed.
怎么说，相对来说，在外边那时那个年代，你挣点钱回来，家里挺富裕，给他们一起都介入这个，做着煤炭生意。 经济上比我的房子装修的挺好，我买了那个车，又买了一个装载机，我买了两台装载机。因为当时不上学了，我回来就说让他开那装载机。
我从他身上学到了很多，从事一个新的行业的话，他需要一个过渡的，不是说你能马上都能成功的。
生意做得也挺红火的，车来车往了，每天都是忙忙叨叨的吧，大家伙心里也都挺开心的。
By the 1990s, China's economy was growing fast, hitting a high of over 14% in early 1992.
Beginning the 90s, Coke business in China began to grow much faster.
And everyone had more money in their pockets.
When you see a wave upon wave of foreign company coming to China, the consumer market in China is really ready for them.
The open door policy was taking off.
这么一个说法，到了北京吃烤鸭、逛故宫，一定要喝可口可乐。
联系了，这里看我们当时啊，我们只有几个人，什么都要做，搞生产、搞推销、广告，还有跟政府部门的打交道。
40 years on, Du is responsible for quality control at the bottling plant.He's one of Kofco's 145,000 employees, making it China's largest food processing company.
像改革开放呢，已经40年了。不管是国外的一些公司呢，还是一些国内的一些公司，在各方面呢都有很大的发展，等于是没有很大的区别了。
From 1979 to 2018, I thought I have observed total transformation from one world to the other, two different worlds.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. 请进，请进。我们的生活呢，在不断的进步，不断的在好，一步一步的，在发展。在我们刚刚上班的时候呢，这工厂的路啊，全是小路，很难走。随着发展呢，像我们上班，边上修了高速公路，我们上班呢更快了，而且呢时间呢更短了。
Back in the 90s, and Dong Mingzhu was now general manager at Gree Electrics, a state-owned enterprise that was running into trouble.
The 1990s came upon us and we saw the restructuring of the state-owned enterprises.
China's leaders were really taking on board the idea that they had to privatize industries and instead create a very different sort of environment.
State-owned enterprises weren't there just for production. They were there to maintain social stability. They were there to maintain employment.
当时回来，尤其是出乎我的意料。其实我想象当中这种企业，应该有一定的管理制度。特别是对这个管理者，但回来以后确实发现问题非常严重。
Many of them were building up massive amounts of debt, and they were not competitive.
当时回来，首先第一个发现的就是我们的应收款有5000多万。最后，随着企业后面的发展，
你找谁呀？
每天都有人会敲你的玻璃窗，告诉你说：“董姐，哪里哪里有件什么事，哪里哪个有什么事。”很多人是知道但不敢讲，他们觉得我敢讲，就是越困难，你越有斗志，啊，越难做的事你越去跟他干。终于成功的成为一个公众公司，啊，成为了一个股份制公司。那就在这种情况下，股份制公司的情况下，当时我们的这个国有股还是法人股，它是不能流通的。
Dong Mingzhu would soon get the chance to shine on a bigger stage.
On the accession of the People's Republic of China, the ministerial conference so agrees.
Joining WTO was the fulfillment of Deng Xiaoping's view of where China needed to be.
It was a very, very important moment. And you can see from the statistics, the global trade statistics at that time, the impact that China joining the WTO had.
当这个我们中国加入 WTO 的这个世贸组织的时候，各种舆论啊，包括一些企业啊，都反映出来，大家都是有一种这种恐惧。
It's actually worried about whether China could compete. Products would now be able to come into China with lower tariffs.
But it was also forcing international competition to the enterprises that have just gone from being state-owned enterprises to corporations.
所以我们勇敢的人是会到大海里去游泳，胆小的人或者没有这实力的人就被淹死。但是我认为就是说，就是因为有了这样的一个竞争的机会，让我们的产品能够走向世界。市场经济实际上从过去被动的到今天主动的这个挑战，它是一个转变。
From a largely inward-looking closed economy to an economy which is integrated into the world.China actually becomes a major center of global trading activity.
China has seen very rapid growth in recent decades, but China is also now dealing with some of the environmental consequences of that growth.
What they've got is a particularly dirty sulfurous kind of coal.It was something that made the production cheaper. So you can see what the logic of it was when they were very poor, but now the cost of it has loomed larger and larger. So get off coal.
前工作特别脏特别累，而且工作不怎么样，也不太理想，不是我特别喜欢的，不太理想。
这几年那个煤炭，污染的也太厉害，政府管的也比较严了，要求的也挺认真了。就是从去年吧，去年这个煤炭就是逐渐都取缔了，就是在我们曲阳这边的煤厂，去年都取缔了。
钢铁厂生意不好的事儿，我给我父亲说过。我们两个平常说吧，交谈的时候说，他想让我，因为毕竟年轻的吧，让我先出去闯一下，出去闯一下。我开车的时候，开车有一天路过这里，然后他们在山上施工，然后我挺好奇的，他们在干什么，然后就找到他们的负责人，问了他们一下，他们在干什么，他们说在是安这种太阳能电池板，挺好奇的。
In 2015, there was a very dramatic decision which made China shift very dramatically from a fossil fuel-based economy to one which is a green economy.
Xi Jinping advocates the creation of an ecological civilization where green mountains and clear waters are valued above mountains of gold and silver.
All of that is.Consistent with a country that is middle income and knows that standards of living isn't just money, it's about the quality of life.
I think here China is actually quite ingenious because China actually believes that a green growth strategy is good for the economy. China sees clean technologies as actually a growth driver, not a growth inhibitor.
之所以选择这个新能源行业嘛，它是一个朝阳的、有发展的一个前途的一个行业。再就是国家的这个发展形势，还有世界的潮流。给我父亲的关系现在是互换一个模式。以前是我跟着我父亲干，现在是他跟着我干了。 刚开始从事这个行业的时候特别困难，因为它是新鲜的事物，老百姓他这个接受能力是比较差的。老百姓有了认识度以后，订单自然而然的都多了。
Once the solar panels are installed, the owner can make money by selling green energy back to the grid, but they're expensive to buy. The breakthrough came when a local bank teamed up with Chen Hao. They made loans to customers so they can invest in the panels.
反正现在我也挺高兴的，为他挺骄傲的。总而说他做光伏吧，对环境说，对大家都挺好的。
贡献出了一份力，环境好了，生活环境好了，不光是我们自己，还有孩子的，还有子孙后代的。
Xi Jinping has emphasized that China's sustainable green economy must be founded on innovation.
And it's not an easy task. There's quite a lot of debate about whether the innovations of today will really match the innovations that made the West prosperous during the past industrial revolutions. So can what's invented today be as good as electrification or the internal combustion engine?
I get really kind of angry when I listen to foreigners say there's no innovation in China. This is a common sort of thing. You say, oh, we have in America, we have all kinds of freedom, so we have innovation. This is nonsense.
Today, the generation that made China's 40 years of reform is looking to the next generation and what they will achieve.
中国有句话叫初生牛犊不怕虎。应该讲啊，像那个中关村的这个未来应该讲是非常光明了。
I feel very fortunate to be living in a dream. My name is Cindy Mi. I'm the founder and CEO of VIP Kid. The first VIP Kid office locates in the heart of 中关村。Silicon Valley of China, that's what everyone said about it.
中关村的灵魂就是科技创新，就是要不停的要勇于这个做出新的东西。
VIP Kid is a education technology company, a online platform for students and teachers across the globe. From the comfort of their homes, students can learn from the best teachers.From North America, from the UK, from everywhere.
My name is Doria.
The way it works is magic. It's amazing to launch a business where it's not just in China, but be able to capture a global market.People keep innovating because it's like infinite opportunities.
And an apparently infinite number of young people too, all eager to maintain Zhongguansun's reputation for tech startups into the future.
应该讲呢，这个二十几岁呢是最敢干的时候。
年轻人现在正在成为我们中国的一个主力。
所以呢，他们非常敢做事情。
对于年轻人来讲，即使他没有很多的资金，他有一些新的想法。
我觉得这是一个非常好的一个温室，就是可以让更多的年轻人在这里得到成长和很好的锻炼。
你后面的创新呢，会越走越快。
Fast forward, now we're in 2018. Guess what? Shenzhen is the center of global artificial intelligence investment.
哎，这家公司是我12年前在这里上班的地方。
The toy industry in Shenzhen has now become the robotics industry.
因为之前它只是靠人员人多来组装。工作效率慢，而且废品率又多， 现在就慢慢的利用自动化了一些机器人来完成了。我来深圳35年了啊，生活到整整35年了。如果说要一个词是吧，或者一句话的概括，确实是让我意想不到，可以这样说，确实没有想到的奇迹。
那我们最大的责任就是不断的要培养年轻人，滋生的一个人的生命的使然。
At Aircon Company Gree, CEO Dong Mingzhu has established a 12,000-strong research and development team to tackle environmental issues through tech innovation.
为我们在未来的这个消耗资源的同时，是用一种新型的一种能源来解决。
We're looking at China with not as one trying to, a country trying to emulate the outside world, but one that is itself setting the tone, the pace for many changes that are happening globally.
不能守在自己过去所取得的成绩。我有一句话，就是说，当你站在山顶上的时候，你的头顶还有星空。那就是说，创新是一个永无止境的话题。
In 1978, 4 out of 5 Chinese people worked on the land. Now, more than half live in megacities, bustling communities built on the hard work and creativity of millions of workers, each chasing their own dream.
哎，我觉得这个来深圳，我觉得是我来对的。
In 4 decades of reforms and connecting with the outside world, imagination and risk-taking have swept the country. Young entrepreneurs are pioneering the tech businesses of the future.
I was born in the 1980s, right? We're born way more global, way more fortunate to have access to learn about the world so that we can do whatever we're doing today.
With innovation and imagination,Chinese people continue to build a prosperity earlier generations never dreamt of.
今天的人想象不到40年前中国什么样，40年前呢，那个时候也不会想到今天中国会发展的这样的一个情况。
This is the story of China, opening the door to the world and chasing dreams.